cracks in her eyes. Mother said, "She heard the song."
Oh. testimony. Those two songs are my testimony.
Amen.
So now we're going to get ready to get blessed again by Calvary Missionary Baptist Church. Give us a wonderful time with prayer. Jesus, and I have a chance for eternity, you know. So I'm grateful for that gift and the thing that he brought a baby into this world to teach us and for us to learn as we get older. He has forgiveness each and every day we do something. God forgives us, and that's a gift. Because if it was me, and I know if it was me, I would be forgiving for some of the stuff that would be going on. And so I'm just being real about it because I have to pray on that one. But so I thank God that every year we get a chance to be reminded of the blessing that a child came into this world, had to go through all the stuff that we're going through, or then to stretch out and down that cross for each and every one of our sins, so that we, each one of us here, from all the way back there up in the top and all the way up here, have a chance for eternity. Like, I tell you, we all should have our face lit up with joy, because truly God is good. Now we all get a chance to reach into our pockets and give so that we can keep on keeping the lights on and everything else going. And if you don't have money in your pocket, check it out. Bethel have to wait, they can put it online. And so there's no excuse.
You won't believe what it is. What you mind?
I tell you, that's one of my favorite things for this year. I get my little check before I get paid to buy bill and gas. Go ahead and clip and put my tithes and just say, God, you got it. So, under the directions of Brother Earl and Brother Clint, and following the directions of my ushers, because normally I'll be back there helping ushering. So, let's all just stand up and let's get ready to do what we all can do together. All right?
Follow the directions of the ushers to come back.
all things come to be?
She said about 10 minutes.
Oh,
I just enjoy the song of praises. So right now I'm going to be here for the next on the program, which will be Bethel AME Church Choir.
He's here.
Ross as the soloist. And so let's get ready for the next home church. Get ready to sing praises and stuff. Is everybody having a good time? I know I am. For me to see people coming out in the afternoon when the Seahawks are playing and other teams are playing, they lost. So you guys know what team I'm pulling for. But it's good when people put aside their own little personal interests and come this fellowship together. When you see the different churches and you see all age groups, you got babies here, we got the toddlers running around, then we got people like Mother Kelly here, Mrs. Gaines here, then you got all of us in between. And can you imagine what heaven's going to be like? It's not going to be all this different stuff. It's not going to be a race thing, it's not going to be an age thing, and we're all going to be all up in heaven, just one heavenly being, just praising God. And the beauty of it is that when you think about Christmas, the kids think about presents. For us, we think about our Holy Savior. And I don't know about you guys, but I get up and I say, thank you, Jesus. All eager to sing, and I just want to say, you know, when the
And let's just have a Christmas celebration. Come on, Brother Warren, you too. Everybody say.
Oh,
Come on, let's give this choir another big hand. To worship simply words that said, hallelujah, hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. If you don't mind, just concentrate on the Lord and don't think about the person next to you and just begin to give God praise as these words go forth. Amen.
Thank you. Did that one? But not like that.
Talk to him, I didn't tell him what it was about. flowers. I didn't want to get ready to say no. But as we fellowship, he was saying, "Oh, I was hoping you would ask me to do that." He said, wanted to do this for a long time. So since Maddie Adams had asked me to be a part of our Christian program, and she's long gone, and we just thank God for you, Reverend Ross, for stepping up, stepping in, and stepping out, and showing up. Just thank God for you. Give the words, and I'll take up Rod's place right now. He had to leave town, so he's not here with us. But I want to thank the choir members who have sweated me out and who have done a beautiful job. I want to thank my husband, who is a diligent worker. And I know he has a lot on his plate. He's deputy superintendent of the school district, Ventura Unified. And so he got a lot of stuff going on that I don't know about. I don't want to say I don't care about, but because you know I won't, you know. But his job had kept him away from what I need. But I do thank him for whatever I need, anything, he comes through every time. I can depend on him.
But that's all right. So at this time, I would just really like to take the opportunity on behalf of the choir's president, Mr. Ronald Greenwood, as mentioned earlier. He does send his well wishes and season's greetings. I would like to say thank you for everyone who was on the program this evening. A special thank you to Ms. Marietta McMahon for your wonderful welcome and your home. And to our awesome mistress of ceremony, thank you very much for your inspiring words. And to the choir, the cathedral choir, the
choir.
Thank you for your time and for singing from your heart. And to our directress and our musicians who do that. To Mr. Calvin Ammons, to Dr. Andrew Tindall, to Mr. and Mr. Aaron Cooper, I say thank you to all of them because they're sharing their God-given talents. They've been blessed and they're sharing it with us to share it with you. I also just want to say thank you to each and every one of you who are in attendance here today to help us celebrate and to usher in the reason for the season. We pray this Christmas brings peace to your homes. May you find happiness, love, and grace. Walk in love. Be kind. Be thoughtful. But most of all, be grateful. Yes, Merry okay. Christmas and Happy New Year to you.
Great to have the cooperation and the support of our sister churches in the community that made this so wonderful. And thank all of you for coming out. And although, you know, we're sort of like on mixed emotions, I shared with the congregation this morning, in the midst of a joyous season, we have just to the north of us this terrible tragedy that has been going on now for 2 weeks and with really no end in sight. So that we have concern for those who have been burned out, those who are still being threatened. And it takes a little bit of the joy out because we can't fully enjoy because there's some that are not in their homes right now. But I thank God for all of you for making this such a wonderful service this evening. Let's give God praise. So, but we want to be in prayer. So might we just close our eyes and look toward heaven. God, you showed us more than 2,000 years ago how much you loved us. Because you came to this earth wrapped in human flesh. And put up with all the indignities of life to give us life. We thank you, God, for Jesus and for this Advent season. And God, we look forward to you coming again. But until then, would you just continue to bless us with your spirit of joy and of love and of friendship that we might look forward to being with you. Thank you, God, for the wonderful talent and gifts that have been shared this evening. Now we ask, God, for safe travels back home and for safety when we find ourselves at home. Thank you for Jesus. And it's in his name that we pray and the church say amen.
Amen.
So why don't we just stand and we wish you a Merry Christmas.